Hello and welcome back to Back to the Future, the game, Volume 2. And last time, I remember, we had to slap a cop straight, even though he was rather stupid of what his decisions were. Man, one song, or a couple of songs will change a man. So, since we taken care of Officer Parker, we should talk to Trixie.
Excuse me, are you Trixie Trotter?
That's what it says on my dressing room door. At least it would if I had a dressing room.
What's a nice guy like you doing with a guy like Tannen?
Kid ain't so bad. He just takes some...
Hey, Toots, any chance you could sing that can-can number? The guys really love the way it shows off your, assets.
Whatever you say, kid.
And quit lazing around. I ain't paying you to yak with the drunks.
You ain't paying me at all, you bum.
Then why are you whipping?
What are we talking about again?
Why do you stay with him?
You were telling me what a great guy Kid is.
Yeah, I guess he is a pretty crummy boyfriend. But until my insurance policy checks out, I guess I'm stuck with him.
Insurance?
Yeah. Look, I may not be the brightest bulb in the marquee, but even I know. You don't break up with a creep like Kid without something to keep him from going all crazy on you.
Insurance policy.
What's this insurance policy all about?
Are you kidding? There's only one person I trust with my secrets. But I ain't seen him in weeks.
You don't mean...
Artie McFly.
Artie McFly.
You know him?
Not as well as I thought.
Before he took a powder, Artie was tutoring me in all sorts of stuff. Etiquette, philosophy, accountant. He's a regular Renaissance man. He even had one of those smart guy professors pipes, see?
Ah.
Can I borrow this?
Sure.
Thank you.
I've been secretly working on my get out of kid card for weeks now. But Artie's the only one I trust to check my work. You can't be too careful when you're dealing with a maniac like Kid, you know?
See, Back to the Future 2.
Break a leg out there.
Thanks.
She's supposed to turn on Kid Tannen tonight? Okay, Doc, if you say so.
Well, there's only one way to do that. We need to go see good old Doc anyway.
Honey, you're just in time.
How have you been, Emmett? I know I haven't seen you in a couple of months.
I'm great, and I owe it all to you.
Really?
Yes. That argument I had with my father during our jet drill experiment gave me the incentive to finally quit that dreary court job. I've committed myself full-time to a life of science.
Good for you.
So, thanks for watching Einstein while I've been... away.
It's been a pleasure. He's proven to be a surprisingly willing test subject. Almost as if he'd been working with me for years.
More like decades. What's the story with the little car and all this equipment?
Einstein and I are conducting a few experiments with this one-quarter scale model to work out a few hitches in my planned demonstration at the Hill Valley Expo in a couple of months.
Valley!
A radio-controlled car?
Or valet?
No. Well, yes, but there'll be so much more than that. It will amaze the world. Aha! Got it!
Got what?
show you. Ready to go, Einstein? Watch this.
You're not going to go to fucker bump.
3 miles per hour? You're going to see some serious cow flop.
The prototype.
Einstein! Oh, get him out of here! Not to worry. I have got a fail-safe eject mechanism around here someplace.
Someplace?
See? Nothing to worry about.
Nothing.
That's supposed to happen.
I'll go see if I can find something to help. Or someone.
To the flop house.
Hey, Doc. How's the room?
It's a little cleaner than I would have imagined for a depression era flop house. How are your investigations going?
Well, you're in the park.
Why didn't you tell me I'd run into your younger self tonight?
Because I don't remember being out here tonight. Clearly, your interactions with my younger self 2 months ago have slightly altered my personal timeline. I never have the nerve to perform public experiments like he's doing. No matter. Those experiments will be forgotten once I've seen Frankenstein.
Frankenstein?
Yes. Right now, my younger self is fiddling around down there with rocket propulsion systems for his demonstration at the expo.
The thing that'll kick off your scientific career.
Exactly. Now, the rockets are a horrible idea, and I'll soon realize that they'll never work. But eventually, I'll wander into that movie theater and see Frankenstein and clear my mind. I've kept the ticket stub from that movie in my wallet ever since. See?
Well, now.
Why?
Because it's during this movie that I'll have the inspiration for my breakthrough at the expo.
It doesn't have anything to do with reanimating the dead, does it?
Not the way you're thinking, no.
Okay.
But during that famous scene when Colin Clive turned the wheel that raised that shrouded figure into the tower, and that bolt of light being struck, well, let's just say more than one brain was reanimated that night.
You better save your dog, man. Just let me know.
Emmett's not having much luck getting Einstein off the courthouse.
I'm not surprised. Einie's a smart dog, but heights give him the willies.
What can we do?
I've got it.
What?
Just get my younger self distracted, and I'll handle the rest.
Okay. You're going to ask me to distract you, your younger self. Okay.
Okay, I better get back to fixing history.
Be careful, Marty.
Couldn't even stay in 1986 for very long, and then all of a sudden, this happens.
Edna!
What?
Hey, I got a hot lead for you.
Oh, what is it?
Well, Whoopi invares Strand's dog on courthouse.
Young scientist Strand's dog on courthouse roof.
What?
Look over there.
Oh, for goodness sake. Mr. Brown!
Please, Miss Strickland, not now. Can't you see I've got a rather delicate situation on my hands at the moment? My trial run...
Trial run? Public hazard, I call it. And I'm sure my editor will agree. This scientific enterprise of yours represents a clear and present danger to public safety.
You don't represent a clear and present danger to public safety. Your singing voice.
Oh. No need to get personal, Mr. Brown.
Believe me, I have no intention of getting personal with you.
I need to hear it. Flying cars of all the ridiculous human
you must be, but just imagine a world in which traffic jams and car crashes are a thing of the past.
I might be more inclined to listen to you if your maiden voyage hadn't ended in a crash on one roof and a stranded dog on another.
I'm working on getting him down. Einie, how'd you get down? Clever dog.
Well, fortune favors you tonight.
but I warn you to be more careful in the future.
Now, how to get that rocket car back down?
Well, let's whip this bad boy out and use it on Einstein.
Hey, boy, take a whip of this.
Get him, boy!
Gotta love that nose.
I've been laying low, officer, but I've gotta go to the pictures once in a while.
Hello, officer.
Officer?
I'll take it from here.
But?
We can talk in the Majestic, away from prying eyes.
Yeah, Einstein, you done good.
You done real good. So, we head back to the flop house.
Hey, Doc, I could use a little help.
What's the problem?
Is Artie still here?
He's in the bathroom.
Hey, Artie, open up. You've got a gangster to bring down.
Is it time for me to meet this Sylvia?
No, it's time for you to meet Trixie.
Trixie says she's got something that might be able to send Kid up the river, but that you're the only one she trusts to check it out.
Me? What is she... Oh, I know what she's done. Clever.
Care to let us in on the secret?
Sorry, guys, but if Trixie's keeping it a secret, then so am I.
That's all well and good, Mr. McFly, but if you and Trixie are going to collaborate on this evidence, we'll need to arrange a rendezvous.
Well, Trixie's chained to Kid's speakeasy.
So we'll have to bring Arthur to Trixie's.
Uh-uh. No way am I getting anywhere near that place again. I don't know how you talked me into this.
Stay back here in the shadows and don't come out until you see Trixie.
You're sure I'll be safe here?
Perfectly safe. We'd never make you take any unnecessary...
Rip.
Sagan. Where's Kid?
Don't worry.
I got this.
Welcome back, sir.
I do it once, I don't have to do it again.
What's it gonna take to get Trixie to squeal on Kid?
Oh, I got ways, but...
Trixie?
Yeah?
No. She's outside.
Guess who's waiting in the alley to talk with you?
Buddy?
The one and only. It wasn't easy to track him down.
Come for me, cue ball. I'm taking a smoke break.
Atta girl.
Hey, you!
Huh?
Yeah, jerk. I saw you making eyes at my unit.
What?
Sorry, pal. I don't have time for a fight.
Why, you?
You're drunk, aren't you?
I'll never get to Carnegie Hall at this rate. All right, fella. I think you're done for the night. Hey, where do you think you're going?
Me?
Yeah, you. What do you know about this?
Nothing.
I heard that.
Trixie?
Break silver, cue ball.
Whatever you say, babe.
What was that?
Yeah, I know what that means. Mm-hmm. Those two shots? Mm-hmm. We got to go. Wait a minute. What's this?
Artie?
You missed a hell of a party, buddy.
Kid, what happened?
Oh, you're gonna love this. So, I'm hanging out in the club when all of a sudden I get an urge to drain the lizard, right? I come out into the alley, and who do I see? None other than that scrawny subpoena-answering rat, Artie McFly. And get this. The little worms whispering away all conquistadorial like with my Trixie.
Oh, no.
Naturally, I pull out Kid Jr. and prepare to put a couple bullets in McFly's head, which causes Artie's nose to stop bleeding because he's a big wuss. And then...
What?
And then... What? Trixie literally gets down on the knees and begs me to let him live.
Huh? What?
Seriously, down on the knees, crying and begging for McFly's life.
So, what did you do?
What could I do? I fired two shots in the air and told Artie to take a hike.
What?
Oh, that was merciful.
Hey, I got plenty of mercy. Besides, now Trixie owes me big time. And Kid Tannen always collects on his debts.
Lovely.
Always.
Lovely. Back inside. Yeah, just back inside.
Welcome back, sir. Boss?
Do you mind? I'm trying to have a good time here.
I think you'll want to see this.
Are you crazy? Bringing a stick of dynamite into my club?
That's just it, boss. It's all over the place. I think our speakeasy arsonist is getting ready to strike again.
Hell man. Quite a joker, isn't he?
What's it gonna take to get Trixie to squeal like Kid?
Oh.
Hey, bartender.
What'll it be?
So about this, portrait gallery of yours.
What about it?
What's it all about? Who are those guys?
The caricatures hanging along the Wall of Honor commemorate those who are no longer with us on account of having ticked off one Irving Kid Tannen.
Irving?
The guys that Kid's killed?
Well, of course not. They're just a bunch of guys that Kid didn't particularly like and that at a later date turned up dead. It's a circumstantial coincidence.
Circumstantial
yeah.
Coincidence.
Thanks for the talk.
Next time, order a drink. This ain't no library, you know.
I think we know what to do with this right here.
Not sure what that'll do.
you think you could draw a picture of this guy?
Sure. Hey, that looks like that Artie McFly Fink.
I never noticed that before. Hey, can you give him a hat like Artie wears?
Voila!
Nice job.
Now, go tell them chumps at the New Yorker.
That's a nice caricature, George.
Sorry about this, Dad.
This reminds me so much of the old cartoons, the old Looney Tunes, with they show these caricatures of the actual people behind the scenes of the cartoon. That's what reminds me of, like Tex Avery and Mel Blanc, that sort of thing. So the next thing we do is, well, we put an end to this. So Trixie. How's Trix, girl?
Trixie?
Yeah?
I don't know how to tell you this, but I think you should check out the Wall of Fame.
Why? What is it?
Look.
Artie! I don't believe it! We had a deal! Artie was supposed to be safe!
I don't know what to say.
Well, I do. Felony tax evasion.
Oh,
what?
Before he died, Artie was teaching me about all sorts of stuff. Literature, history, accounting. And I made a big discovery while I was copying all of kids' books. This establishment ain't entirely on the up and up.
Really?
Oh, I knew about all the gangster stuff. That kind of thing you expect from tough guys like him. But when I found out he ain't been paying taxes on his speakeasy profits, well... Cheating Uncle Sam is one step over the line. Once I turn this over to the police, they'll throw the book at him. This book. Hey, copper!
You, yeah.
What happened to my louse of an ex-boyfriend?
I don't know. Rats. I told the chief we need a team of bloodhounds like they got over in Placerville. Yeah, but in the meantime... All right, everyone. Party's over. Everyone out of the speakeasy.
Speakeasy?
You're mistaken, officer. This is an ice cream parlor. Nice try, you. Out!
Parker finally got his balls.
Crockett. Would the Valenti mob be willing to help defuse this little situation?
Yeah.
Sure, no problem. I'll bring it up at the next company meeting.
Hey, we ain't begging here. Kid just thought JJ might like a piece of the action. Especially now that he's just caught the speakeasy arsonist.
Wait, you mean Doc?
Doc? You ain't with the Valenti gang at all, are you? What do you know about the arsonist?
Come on, you. Off to the station house.
Kid's gonna get you, Rat. He's gonna get all of you.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, yeah. Well, that's that. Thanks to Miss Trotter's evidence, the entire Hill Valley police force is out looking for Kid and his goons.
You don't understand. We've got to find him now. He's captured a friend of mine.
Who?
Never mind.
Don't worry. We've got the entire town square sealed off. If Tannen's within a mile of here, we'll find him eventually.
I don't think we have time for eventually.
Hill Valley's finest, ladies and gentlemen. Hill Valley's finest. So. Let's go find him and put an end to him, shall we?
The only thing I want to break this bottle on is one of those goons' heads.
Let's see. There's a flask behind the trash cans.
Ew.
Right here.
Irving Kid Tannen. Guess he dropped this on his way out. It's empty. Figures.
Ah, but even if it's empty, we have a clue. Arnie, got a job for you.
Hey, Arnie, get your nose over here. All right. I really don't think Tannen and Doc are with Herbert Hoover, Arnie. Okay, I'll check it out. A button.
Push that button.
All right, Doc. Here I come.
Crockett, what are you doing here?
Never mind. Come here and help me get rid of this stinking arsonist.
Edna?
I caught her planting dynamite while he was clearing out the soup kitchen. Guess Sagan was innocent after all.
I was researching a story, you ignoramus!
Tell it to St. Peter, sister.
Hey, what's all this?
Parker? Tannen. You're under arrest. Get him, Sacramento boy.
I can't do that, kid.
What? Oh, I get it. Why don't you let go of Miss Strickland and call it a night?
Hey, look over there. Watch out.
Give it up, Tannen. The alley's blocked off and so are the roads out of town. It's over.
Over?
Nothing is over until Kid Tannen says it's over.
Barrels.
Make it easy on yourself, Tannen.
Tannen never make things easy.
Go, Tannen. Make like a tree and die, rat.
Shouldn't it be Leaf? Police car.
No one messes with Kid Tannen.
Hey, kid,
let phony.
Hey, moron.
Moron, this.
Yo, Tannen,
make like a tree and die, rat.
Trash cans.
Are you shooting at me? Are you shooting at me?
Barrels. And let's see.
I could do this all night, Parker.
What am I looking for?
Make it easy on yourself, Tannen. Tannen. Tannens never make things.
And we got something for that hooch trail.
Hey, kid. That ain't a real gun.
Oh, right. I forgot. I better just get rid of it then.
Oh, crap.
Getting
away!
Oh, no.
Yeah. No. There! Good as new.
Oh, look, Tanner.
The judge's son.
All right, Parker. I want a getaway car and a clear road to Nevada, or the brown kid gets it.
Stop.
Doc?
Yes, it's me.
I'm talking to you through the radio apparatus my younger self has installed in the locker car. What's going on up there?
It's not good, Doc. Trixie and Parker did their part, but now Kid's holding you hostage.
Right, Scott.
No kidding.
Try to get Kid in the car. Once he's inside, give me a signal, and I'll do the rest.
How am I...
You!
That works.
Emmett.
That don't work.
You're the cause of all of this, ain't you?
Okay, that kind of works.
Should have known. I mean... No one makes a fool out of me, you backstabbing twerp!
Guess I'm...
Any last words, rat?
None that you'd understand.
Hey! Stop, get it!
Yeah, I got one. Bye. Well, shit.
Irving Tannen, I'm placing you under arrest for kidnapping, attempted murder, tax evasion,
and smelling like a piece of crap.
Tax evasion?
Haven't you heard? The feds are practically drooling over Trixie's books.
Trixie?
Yep.
That's what you get for killing Artie, you bastard!
What? I didn't...
Trixie?
Artie?
Then they're supposed to be changing things.
All right, Grandpa.
My poor car.
I believe I owe you an apology, Mr. Brown. Thanks to your ridiculous contraption, Hill Valley's most notorious criminal is finally headed to prison.
Apparently.
No apologies necessary, Miss Strickland. My rocket car may have accidentally saved the day, but only because it's a completely out-of-control failure. I need a new idea.
If you're willing to listen, I might have a few suggestions.
Oh, dear.
But first... I think we should take in a movie.
I'm all yours, Mr. Brown.
I think you'll like it. It's all about a brilliant scientist with an overabundance of hubris.
Whew. Come on, Einie. Let's go find Doc. Huh?
And so...
That's
we head back
DeLorean, Doc.
To 1986.
I'm absolutely sure that everything's back to normal.
Yes.
Totally.
No.
Kid's going to jail, Emmett's going to see Frankenstein, and there's no such thing as a Tannen crime family in 1986. And we remembered Einstein this time, too.
Hill Valley crime rate at all time low.
Well, except for Grandpa necking with Trixie, I think we're ready to go back to 1986.
Are you sure about that?
You feel yourself fading out of existence?
No.
Then as long as your father's still born in 7 years, I say, let your grandfather sow his oats.
Sowing oats? Is that what's going on with you and Edna?
What are you talking about?
Yeah.
Emmett and Edna, they're gonna go see Frankenstein together.
And then this happened.
That's odd.
And then that happened. Oh dear. Yeah. Famous last words, right? So, that was Back to the Future, Episode 2. Get Cannon, and in the next episode...
Martin McFly, age 18.
Okay, Doc, let's see what kind of nightmare alternate timeline I've landed in this time.
Father George, Mother Lorraine...
Hill Valley under Citizen Brown. It's not quite the contented town you were led to believe it was. A re-education program? What the hell?
Please don't swear, Martin. It makes me uncomfortable.
Zero demerits. I'll kill this morning.
We're through, McFly. I'll never date such a square again.
My own girlfriend thinks I'm a square?
The obvious question, Mr. McFly, is what happened to you?
Jesus Christ, now, what happened to you?
So next time, episode 3, Citizen Brown. By the way, I own none of these properties that are right that you're seeing right now. So I'll see you next time when we do episode 3 or volume 3 of Back to the Future: The Game. Thanks so much for watching. And I'll see you in episode 3.